Your favorite series is not peak. Stop it. Like, just fucking stop, dude. I'm not just saying this to be some annoying cunt that's like, oh, you're not allowed to like things, you're not allowed to... I'm not going against liking shows. I'm going against the stupid fucking mindset that the entire anime community has, where when they're a fan of something, whatever that thing is infallible and can do no wrong in their eyes. They perceive whatever show as, like, the greatest thing of all time with zero flaws, and not only can they not just point out the obvious things wrong with it, whenever anyone else points out these things to them, they get so defensive, going on these huge tirades, these fucking walls of text, sending a damn tsunami of words at whoever is criticizing their show, when it's not above criticism, because guess what? Nothing fucking is. I don't know what's so hard about just going, oh yeah, I mean, it's got a couple things wrong with it, but I like it. Like a normal human being. Hell, I like things that I wouldn't even consider to be objectively good overall. Literally, Asta is my favorite shonen protagonist ever. Probably one of my favorite protagonists in anything ever. Not my favorite, but he's up there. Asta's a generic-ass character. I like the guy, but like any trait you could use to describe a generic shonen protagonist falls into Asta, because he is just that. I still like him, I still watched all of Black Clover and enjoyed it, but like, will I sit here and try to talk about Asta in some dumbass 15-minute video why Asta is the peak of shonen? No, because he's not! Will I do that for Black Clover as a whole? Also no! You know why? Because that shit is mid, and I can acknowledge that. But God forbid you try to explain any of that to a Black Clover fan online, because if you do, all 13 people who watch that series will descend from the heavens and come up with the wildest fucking takes ever made to win an argument, quote-unquote, win an argument against you when you point out a very obvious flaw with the show. Just in a couple of searches alone, for the purposes of this specific part of this video, I found this guy seeing somebody complaining in detail about why he did not like the last three arcs of the manga that are happening and referring to that entire thing as a nitpick. Also, shout out this fucking goober above him.
All people do here is talk about the downfall of the series, Lamau. If it's that big a deal, just stop reading.
Yes. In the dedicated community for discussing Black Clover, you're not allowed to discuss Black Clover unless you're just glazing it endlessly while ignoring the 20 million problems with the series. That makes sense. Good job. No, but then I found this guy arguing with somebody about better shonens. He mentioned Full Metal Alchemist, and he said, quote, "I've already seen Full Metal, and it's not better than anything in Black Clover." What? And then there's this fucking one comparing Luck to fucking Kenpachi from Bleach. You can't make these people up, man. You really can't. But even though I'm using Black Clover as my main example here, sorry, Black Clover fans, I know there's at least a couple of you that are sane. I feel like this is still a problem with most anime fandoms, where they're extremely... feral is the first word that comes to mind, but feral and defensive when it comes to people criticizing the series they like. Even when it's people from within their own fandom who read the thing or watched the thing and like it as much as they do. Now, I'm sure there's a lot of exceptions. Probably for more obscure series, because a lot of the main ones are... It's that thing where the more popular something gets, the more annoying people find it, and then it's a whole... There's a fucking diagram of this somewhere, I'll probably put it up in the video. But, there is hope. A shining ray of light in the darkness, and it is known as Jujutsu Kaisen. You are my special. Now, this series definitely has one of the more, let's say interesting, let's go with interesting fan bases I've seen so far. I think they're pretty funny. If you don't like this type of humor, if you can even call whatever the hell this is humor, that's understandable, but we're not here to talk about that today. We're here to talk about the fact that when the author does some bullshit in Jujutsu Kaisen, they aren't fucking having it! Every other series I see, it's constant fucking glazing, defending dumb writing decision after dumb writing decision, all the time. It's so fucking annoying that I decide to make an entire video about it. But Jujutsu Kaisen is the first fanbase I've ever seen of something this popular, where not only are they like, oh yeah, this is totally wrong with the series, but you should still give it a watch. Like, that's what made me want to watch it in the first place. It wasn't even all the things for season two. I was like, I don't know, season one seems kind of generic. I didn't really like Yuji as a character. I didn't like some of the ways the villains were set up. And a guy straight up told me, like, yeah, those are problems with the show, but these parts get better, these parts stay about the same, and I think overall it's worth it. And I was like, wow, what a reasonable human being. I might actually watch this show. And yeah, it was pretty good. Happy I found one of the reasonable members of the Jujutsu Kaisen fanbase and not the people that make whatever the hell this is. But that brings us to my topic right now. Afterwards. After the Shibuya incident, the really good part, season 2, the thing that got a lot of people hooked, of course, once that came out, a lot of people went, wow, that was fucking incredible, I'm gonna read it now, and noticed a pretty stark decline in the writing from here to here. I wouldn't say it was a complete nosedive, but if I had to describe how well-written Jujutsu Kaisen is across its entire runtime slash write time, it looks something like this. Maybe this if you didn't like Culling Games. I liked Culling Games, but that's besides the point. The bottom line is Jujutsu Kaisen's... I'm gonna call it JJK, this is too much to say. JJK's fanbase does not put up with some of the bullshit that the author does in this, and calls the series out for lazy writing, bad decisions, and rushed plot lines. Instead of constantly fucking glazing the show for every little decision, this is fucking incredible, best manga ever made, you need to read it, and instead of defending it to the bitter end, tooth and nail, whenever somebody points this out, they go, yo, this is kind of fucked up, like, what is this? Actually, wait, spoiler warning. You're gonna tell me you fucking off-screened Gojo Satoru? You're gonna tell me you off-screened Kashimo after hyping up this much? You're telling me Maki died in one chapter? What the fuck kind of writing is this? Gege cannot keep getting away with this shit, man. He just can't. And you know what? Thanks to the JJK fanbase, he kind of isn't. Now, with all that being said, I still very much enjoy Jujutsu Kaisen. I still very much enjoy its fanbase outside of just bashing on the stupid writing decisions. Even though they're an incomprehensible slew of nonsense, the Lobotomy Kaisen memes are pretty funny. The regular memes about Jujutsu Kaisen are pretty funny. I like the fan art, the little fan animations, the headcanon. Seeing all of that is great. I'm not saying that every fan base should turn into a hate clan towards the thing that they're supposed to be centered around liking. That doesn't really make sense. What I am saying is that criticism is necessary and important towards any piece of media. It's important to the author so they can write something better and stop doing stupid things. It's important to the fans to be able to reasonably voice their thoughts and opinions on the series without just getting dunked on by the entire rest of the community. And it's important to people who aren't fans of the series, who are considering watching the show. Back to Black Clover. The reason why I considered watching Black Clover in the first place was because I thought the theme songs were really cool, and I wanted to be able to hear the theme songs with the context of what was happening in the show. However, I had heard a lot of bad things about Black Clover in the recent years. When I started watching it, I think, like, the last arc of the anime was wrapping up. I got to episode 270, whatever it ended on, the day it aired. So, I had a little bit of ways to go, and from what I had heard from the series, it didn't look like a ways that would have been all that entertaining for what I was trying to get out of it. And one day, I just saw a post online talking about, oh, Black Clover theme songs go so hard, and that's how I found it. I just commented on there. I said something along the lines of, oh, these are really good theme songs. I kind of want to watch the show just because of these, but I've heard, like, a lot of bad stuff about it. And a guy responded to me. He said something along the lines of, okay, here's my thoughts on the series. Overall, it's pretty average shonen. If you enjoy shonen, you'll like this show. If you don't enjoy if you generally enjoy shonen and aren't expecting some incredible masterpiece, you'll probably like this show. If you don't enjoy shonen in general, you probably won't like this show. Also, Asta is extremely annoying for the first 15 episodes, and a lot of the side characters are very one-dimensional for the entire first couple of seasons. But if you can get past all of that, There's entertainment to be had, and I think by the Sea Temple arc, you'll know if you're a fan or not. And then he put in parentheses, like, I think it was 40 episodes in, 50, who knows. I'm doing this based off memory, man. I can't find Instagram comments from over 3 years ago. But because he said this, if he had told me that Black Clover was actually some incredible masterpiece that got hated on for no reason, and I watched the first episode of Black Clover where it was just Asta yelling about how he wants to fuck Sister Lily and become the Wizard King, I would have turned that shit off on episode one and thought this man was a clown. But because I got told, oh, yeah, it's kind of bad for the first couple of episodes, but if you get through it, it'll be worth, I got to that point and went, oh, okay, cool, I was warned about this. I'll keep going, though. This theme song kind of slaps, and I like the character designs. And I ended up liking it by the Sea Temple arc. Honestly, a little bit before then. I thought the setup to the whole magic stones and the elves being a thing was actually really interesting. I see why the Sea Temple arc was touted as the part. That shit was some heat, but I started to like it before then. And again, Asta, favorite character in anything ever. But that would not have happened. There's no world where that would have happened if he just started trying to glaze it and get me to watch episode one, and I watched it and that shit was trash. So to the people who cannot comprehend any sort of criticism towards their favorite series, stop it. You're not helping the series, you're not helping other people who might want to watch the series, and you're not helping yourselves. And to the members of the JJK fanbase, bruh, Kusakabe is fucking cooked, dog. There's no way he's winning this damn fight.